I have no idea about Zoom. Yeah, that is being live streamed.
So this is on YouTube.
Yeah.
So people can join through YouTube as well.
But they will not be able to ask questions.
Yes. So they will not be able to ask questions or put it on the chat box. That's not possible.
But sir, they can put it on YouTube link and the host can do the same on their behalf.
Host will be able to see that?
Yeah, host will be able to see the YouTube questions. And if they found something useful, they can directly Muradian, sir.
No, but the point is, will the host be able to see in the chat box on Zoom?
Yeah, not in chat box of Zoom. They'll be able to check it on the YouTube link itself.
Oh my God, there are so many people waiting. Hello, I'm in the waiting room. I can see.
Yeah, sir.
What's gone wrong? Do we have to sign in again?
Sir, there is no issue from our side. We had made the payment for 500. I don't know why it's showing 100.
Lots of people are waiting in the waiting room. I can see their names. I just checked.
I think there is something wrong, Angela and Lakshmi, something.
Oh, sir, but we have checked. We have made the payment as well.
Yeah, Omkar has raised his hand.
Hi, sir. My name is Omkar Muri. So there is an option to select, I think, how many participants you want to join. So my team, 100 was selected by creating the room.
Where?
I think while creating the room, there's an option to select like how many participants are allowed. So like, I think you can set a limit.
How do you click it? Where do you click it?
I'm not sure about it. I've never used a feature, but I've heard that there is an option for that.
It's not like that.
Okay, sorry.
My God. This is a washout, it seems.
Lakshmi, is it possible if you can check in settings if there is any such option available?
I'm checking there.
Let's give 10 minutes to resolve issue, then we will start.
Yeah, we will.
There's a lot of people in the waiting room, I'm finding now.
Yeah, there are a lot of people are waiting. So let us...
If I click on participants, there's an arrow upwards. It takes me to the waiting room. And my God. There's more than 100 there.
Are in the waiting room.
Yes.
So that means more than 200. So I think it's
my assumption was about 200 to 220 will
attend. Yeah. So 100 is already in and 110, 120 are waiting. So 210, 220. So I think it is worthwhile waiting for 5 minutes and
we will wait. We'll wait till they resolve
it. Yes. I think it will be unfair for. Lakshmi, could you fix it?
Yeah, sir. I'm doing that.
Ask Supriya, no, Lakshmi. If she has arranged it, she should know.
Yeah, she is also checking, sir.
I don't think it is in our control to do anything here. I'm trying. only be the organizers who can do it.
So organizer is Lakshmi and Supriya. Supriya, can you do something?
Yeah, sir, she's doing, she called me just now. She's doing something. She's checking with Zoom people.
Sorry for making you all wait, who came on time. At least you are the lucky few who could get through.
I think I'm feeling more bad about people who have not. Yes, Omkar, you want to say something?
Hi, sir. Sorry to disturb again, but I got one solution from one of my batchmates.
Yeah.
So if someone can try it. So the person who has created a room, so it is written that he or she has to sign into the web portal, click on the, sorry.
Yeah, you go ahead.
Sign in the Zoom web portal, then click on the room management.
Lakshmi, are you doing it?
Lakshmi, are we doing that? What Omkar is saying?
I'm trying, sir, but I think some problem with the Zoom only, sir.
Try this now. Click on the web portal. So someone has sent me this solution. So if it might work, then it will.
Now, right now, meeting is going on. No? So we can't make the changes over there.
No, means like he sent me the solution. I think he got it from the web. So
and Nimish Bhai has raised his hand. Yeah, Nimish Bhai.
I think we need to start because I too have another meeting at 7:45.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So I think let us start. In the meantime, let them find a solution to that. With your permission, can I start, sir?
Please.
And we would be recording this meeting because post the meeting, we put it on our YouTube channel for the participants to see later. So hope you are okay with that, sir.
Okay, we'll see.
So, yeah. Lakshmi, you can start recording the meeting.
Yeah.
So, good evening, everybody, and we welcome you to the next episode of our Wednesday Wisdom webinar. And today's session is on the masterclass by Mr. Boman Maradian. And the topic today is automation myths and realities. I think this is a very, very pertinent topic today because everybody is talking about automation and many times we see in practical sense that in the urge to get automation, we sometimes, put ourselves in a situation where we take wrong decisions. And today's speaker comes with a wealth of experience of around 46 years which I think is enormous. And he will be touching on the pitfalls of blindly following the automation of operations process and will provide guidelines to managers for making optimum decisions on factors to consider for and not for automating a process, where to automate and when to automate, and how to view the challenges to be faced. The focus will be on learning through practical life cases rather than theoretical concepts based on his experience. And the webinar will be useful for managers in their discrete manufacturing organizations. So Mr. Bhoman Maradian is a BE mechanical from VJTI and holds a post-graduation graduate degree in management studies with specialization in operations from Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies. He has industry experience in production, HRD, marketing, advertising, and management consulting. Wow, what a wealth of experience. And is in his career spanning 46 years. He is a management consultant in the field of operations management and has assisted organizations improve productivity and thereby profitability, and have been involved in several turnarounds. He is a visiting faculty at Jamnalal Bajaj Institute for over 44 years. I mean, some of the students which he mentioned in the beginning at my individual talk with him are our past presidents and our current treasurer. So senior people have been his students. So we can just imagine the kind of knowledge which he carries with him. He's an independent director on boards of few listed and private limited companies. Sir, we welcome you to this program and we are really thankful for you to spend your time. And I'm sure it will be very useful for the young minds who have joined this program and been on time. Sir, all is yours.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Rajesh Sharma, for the kind words and sentiments. Thank you for giving me the privilege of addressing this young crowd in the field which is I hold very close and dear to my heart. I'm going to talk about operations, automation in operations, okay? Like, for example, you may have a fantastic product or a service. We are not talking about the technology of the product or the service. We are talking about operations which created this product or the service. So how this product or how this service was delivered, how was the product made? So let's start. I must acknowledge that I have taken data from a lot of credible sources. Now I'm using the word credible sources because when you will attend seminars and workshops where you invite speakers, you must first ask them, what is their interest in the subject? Do they have something to sell? Unfortunately, the speakers have something to sell. In general, I'm talking. I have nothing to sell. I'm not selling you anything. I'm just communicating to you some conceptual framework. I have nothing to sell. I have no personal interest in any sales. So be very careful when you listen to people or when you read articles. Check the credentials, okay? That's very important. Otherwise, you'll, you know, automated guided vehicle, either robot laga, wo laga, falana, dimka, buch, marne wala hai jaldi. Be careful. Now let's start. How is automation defined by Cambridge Dictionary? Is the use of machines and computers that can operate without needing human control. There's another definition they give, which is very similar. The use of machines or computers instead of people to do a job, especially in a factory or office. In a way, you can say the skills which the human brought to the job are now going to be replaced by the equipment which is programmed to perform the job. It's as simple as that. The skills are now built into the equipment. Now, you must be very clear where we don't need to debate. Where is automation a must? There's nothing to debate. Okay, so let's draw the boundary of what we are not going to look at because there is a must. There's nothing to debate there. When safety is a concern, when the job itself is hazardous or is done in a hazardous environment, to hell with your cost benefit analysis. You need to automate that. That's not negotiable. Second is, human efforts are tiresome and wearisome. Short cycle time jobs, you know, say pasting a label on a bottle, the water bottle that you drink, it's huge numbers. A human can do it, but it's going to be monotony, it's going to be boring, and the person will wear off personally over a period of time, mentally will also get upset. Those are the jobs which are candidates for being automated. Third is, when the volumes are large and the varieties are low. Say, for example, bagging cement of 50 kilo bags in a cement plant, which has a capacity of 2 million tons per annum, you can't do it humanly. It's difficult. How many people will you employ? Maybe you'll have to have the combined armies of India and China together to do that. Huge volumes. You will not be able to do it at all. There are jobs which are not possible to perform the job by humans. See the dashboard of the car, a human can't make it. It has to be molded by a machine. So there's no question, we will automate that. And the last one is continuous process plant, like oil refineries, etc. Again, they belong to the large volume category and they are continuous. There's no human intervention anyway there. So there's no question of humans to be brought in. Last one is very important and I'll spend some time on it. Today, what is humanly being done? There will be variabilities. Humans will vary in their output and quality. There are variations. That is what we call as voice of the process. This is a term used by Toyota. What is my process saying? How much variation will be there? And there is something called voice of the customer. What is it that the customer wants? In effect, if this is the voice of the customer in terms of quality, and this is the voice of the process, you can clearly see the process limits will be much larger when the human is working as compared to an equipment. The equipment will have a higher frequency around the mean, and the standard deviation will be lower. That means my process is not capable of meeting what the customer wants. And this process, if it's operated by a human, we have no choice but to automate. Otherwise, we'll be out of the market. Now, when you talk to managers in production and in services, what are your objectives for automation? First thing will come to them is reduces labor headcount. Aadmi kam karne ka hai. You see, interestingly, machines don't need motivation theory, leadership style. They don't take, toilet breaks, lunch breaks. They don't need Diwali breaks, Christmas breaks, Eid breaks, nothing. It reduces and they don't form a union. It improves the speed of delivery is what they claim in manufacturing. You can make things faster and deliver faster. Improves quality and ensures zero errors and improves the flexibility. You can do large number of different kind of jobs when you have an equipment as compared to a human being, fundamentally achieving lower cost per unit. That is the objective when they specify. Now, what are the factors to consider? Please understand that. According to McKinsey survey, 90% of jobs which are done in the world, 90% of all the jobs which are carried out in the world, and 64% of manufacturing activities can be automated with current technology available. What will it save? 3 trillion labor costs. Now just imagine 90% of these jobs will be saving $3 trillion. What is the world's economy? $87 trillion. So what the hell are you saving? By creating such large unemployments, you will have a social cost to bear. Now, that's none of our business. That's government's business everywhere around the globe. Some other jobs will be created, like maintenance of this equipment, but they will never be in numbers equal to the workforce, which will become redundant. Interestingly, 81% of the world's automatable manufacturing hours reside in developing countries. India would be considered as a developing country. So just see the kind of social problems that can arise. I'm just mentioning it. As an individual, as a businessman, I have no business to look at it, but you will ultimately be affected because this is not only the government's problem, it becomes your problem. Also consider the way the costs of automation has come down. For example, the cost of a robo unit from 2017 to 2019 has reduced. Look at the reduction that has happened. But never get carried away even by this figure, because this is only the cost of the robo, but it will require a lot of specific applications, specific peripherals. So the $65,000 robo ultimately will cost you $125,000. That's nearly 80 lakh rupees. Okay. Also remember, the cost of labor and related supply and demand dynamics are very important. What is the cost of your labor? What is the supply demand dynamics? I'll touch upon it later. If workers are in abundant supply and significantly less expensive than automation, this fact could constitute a decisive argument for limited or no automation. I'll just give you an example. I'm just playing you a video of tubes being cartoned, you know, putting inside the inner carton. Okay, just see this. I hope you can see it. Just give me a signal from one of you. Lakshmi, can you see it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is a machine which does the cartoning. It's from a Filipino factory. I hope you can see some of the tubes are missing. It looks as if one in three, but no, it is not like that. Later on, you'll see that. See the cartoning being done. The tubes are also inserted. The cartons are open, and here the last operation would be sealing. This machine, if you notice, is doing 60 tubes per minute and few tubes are missing in between. Now, why I'm showing you this? Because only 3-4 days ago, I was in Baddi in a pharmaceutical company and they were talking about why don't we buy this cartoning machine? And I saw this worker working. Just see now. Now, let us look at the economics of this. There is one operator which is preparing the carton, which we saw in the video. One operator will insert the tube and another operator will close the carton. Now, these three are replaced by the machine. Are you clear? They are replaced by the machine, but somebody has to feed the cartons into the machine and somebody has to feed the tubes into the machine. I'm neglecting that. Now, 60 tubes a minute is what you can measure even in this video. What is the cost per annum? 5 lakh rupees. If this was the cost of labor doing it in Germany, it would be 90 lakh rupees per annum. Cost of labor. But we are talking about India, Bharat. Also, remember, flexibility. These workers can do the same thing for jars, tubes, bottles. And operator can do other tasks if there is no load manually. If this machine was to be bought in India, it would cost 25 lakhs. And also there'll be an interest on that. There'll be a depreciation on that. Flexibility. The moment you change the one variety, the machine has to be set up. So the machine will be underutilized. Maintenance. If there are no orders, the machine will lie idle. Who will do the maintenance of this machine? All indirect costs go up. What about the electricity cost? it will never break even over the next 10 years. And also I can shift my labor to do other kind of works like jars and bottles, whereas this machine can only do cartons of different sizes. It doesn't make economic sense. You will impress your visitors, that's all. And if there is a slight flaw in the carton, the machine will stop working. So I'm just trying to make a point. What is the labor cost? We have got a cost-effective labor. And the labor can work at this speed. You could see that. But engineers love technology, automation. Sir, we must do this, we must do that. Sorry for the language, I tell them. For them, it's like a toy. You understand? Be very careful. You don't have to impress anyone. When was the last time you bought a fabric? Did you ask what technology was used to produce this? When was the last time somebody bought a refrigerator? Did you ask how was this refrigerator produced? Who told you you can't get it without automation or automation limited only? So remember one thing, the customers don't care. Customers don't ask. I didn't ask how this phone was produced. I was looking at the phone. Remember one thing, the customer gives you the revenue. Let's proceed further. What are the other factors to consider? There are benefits beyond labor substitution. Of course, you can get higher levels of output. We have already said, where volumes are huge or enormous, we will not be able to employ people. And also better quality consistency. The standard deviation will be low. And I'm not saying no errors. There will be fewer errors by the equipment. So where to start? Start with processes which are routine, formulaic, successful at replacing jobs with straightforward rules, codes, inputs, outputs. It's simple. Those can be considered as candidates for automation. Don't try and automate complicated jobs. You will have complicated equipment, which will be complicated to maintain and operate. And your utilization may fall down to 40-50%. And I've seen it. I've seen these kind of automated guided vehicles, and I've seen robots in India, utilization being 40%. When it works, it's fantastic. But when it stops because of some problem, boy, oh boy, you should see the chaos it creates. So we say automate if need be, but do the cost-benefit analysis only after you have stabilized the process. What do you mean by stability? It must be first capable. It must meet the voice of the customer. It must be reliable. And it must be repeatable. Eliminate all uncertainties. You know, we jokingly say Murphy's Law. If anything is to go wrong, will go wrong. And in operation, a lot of things keep on going wrong. We don't resolve that and we automate. Automation creates its own kind of Mr. Superior Murphy. It must be repeatable, reliable, and capable. And then see whether cost versus benefits is really worthwhile or not. Are you clear? The last point which I would like to make here is don't just automate. Identify your current technology position. What is your current level of technology which your workmen and management and supervisors and engineers are used to dealing with? Don't bring in very heavy degree of automation. You will go crazy. I have a client. We do a lot of grinding and welding and grinding and buffing and all that. Highly laborious jobs. But people are talking about, why don't we automate this? Why don't we automate that? I think now the participants have gone up to 103, so they can be allowed. Huh? I hope, Supriya, you're listening and okay. So what is your current level? We don't have any expertise or experience in dealing with robots. My quality is bound to improve of grinding and buffing, also welding, but we are not ready. We are not there at all. If we just bring in automation, we will go crazy. Utilization will become 20-30%. And there's going to be a training period of how to handle the operation by our current workmen. And who's going to maintain it? So I'll have to create maintenance team. then the other thing which I'll have to do is, first of all, understand that this can only work in an air-conditioned environment. And then it will require certain humidity and certain dust-free environment. Boy, oh boy, the peripheral costs keep on going up. There are recorded cases of how companies have created blunders when they were not ready for that degree of automation. So this is a very important thing. You cannot talk about quantum leap. Oh, we'll have a quantum leap. Yeah, it'll be a leap down the valley. Okay. Now let me share one example with you. I came across this case about 5 years ago, if I'm not mistaken, round about that, about a researcher by the name Jonathan Zarnow. Yeah, it was 5-6 years ago. 2015, he had a grant of $10,000. Please understand, he rented a programmable robo arm, bought a sewing machine and an ultrasonic welder to make t-shirts. So let us see how this robo stitches t-shirts, okay? I hope you can see it. Rajesh sir, you can see it, hear it?
Yes, yes, it is very clear.
I came across this video on CNN Money. So I downloaded it and I talked to my brother-in-law who runs a garment manufacturing unit. It's reasonably large, about 80 tailors. I showed it to him. He got excited. Arre, mast hai re, apne ko kuch karne ka aisa. You know, everybody gets excited when you see technology. So I told him, hold on. One requirement for automation is large volume, low variety. So where is your large volume, low variety? None. So then we did a search on the internet and found out there is one garment which is required in huge quantities and only 6 varieties. And what was that? The US Army combat trousers. Okay. Combat trousers for the US Armed Forces, 8,000 per day, 2 million per year in different sizes, small, large, medium, kya kya hai, extra large. Now we did a proper research on this. Okay, if we were to stitch this, and by the way, it is complicated. It has 64 places where stitching gets done. 64 areas, God knows, there's a pocket here, there's a pocket there, there's something here, something inside, something outside. We decided to look out for robots which can do this job and we located. Then we studied the robot's requirements. It has what kind of environment will it work? It requires some dust-free environment up to so many micrograms per cubic meter, etc. It requires, it can only work in certain temperature range and certain humidity range. So we have to create an environment. So now you can understand the peripheral costs, how they go up. Who's going to maintain it? We started studying maintenance of these. And if we were to do it by our normal tailors, what will the economics look like? Please understand, I'm not looking at pre-stitching and post-stitching. I'm only looking at replacing my tailors with robots, which can do a similar job. And the results came out like this. I'm talking about it being assembled, you know. There's a left side, right side, back side, front side, and what have you, pockets, etc. Since Jonathan Zarnow called it Subo, our traditional method, I called it non-Subo. To fulfill this order, our operating fixed assets will become $18 million. Whereas if I buy the normal stitching machine, to cater to this order, it would be $1.2 million. The skills are with the operator here. The skill is in the robot. But what about the operating expenses per annum? Look at the saving. It's only 0.4. Why did it come down? Not much in same proportion. And by the way, I've not even looked at interest and depreciation in this, which is itself a major cost. I've not looked at that. It will never make sense. Why? Because of the labor supply dynamics. Now just see this. I have brought some data here. A skilled labor, and I have been involved in a company where I was on the board of directors. We had 2 plants in US, we had in Germany 2 plants, we had 3 in China, we had 4 in India, we had 1 in Philippines, we had 1 in Egypt, we had 1 in Russia, 1 in Colombia, 2 in Mexico, and so on. Look at the labor cost, skilled labor. US is $35 an hour. Germany, I've converted everything to dollars, is $46 an hour. China is only $1.8 an hour. In India, skilled labor is $1.3 an hour. Look at the average age. 39 years, 44 years, 39 years. China has deteriorated over the last 15, 20 years because of that one-child policy. And in India, this average is median age, by the way. National median age is 29. Now, till 2030, US is only going to add 2 million to this workforce. Obviously, this is going to go up because people will not be available. Germany, there's going to be a decline of 3 million people into the workforce and an aging population. This is going to go up dramatically. Recently, I read an article, credible article, where the German government is looking at minimum wage for totally unskilled labor to be 17 euros an hour. Unskilled. We are talking about skill. China, the addition to the population, there are conflicting data coming in, so I've left it blank. But in India, we are going to add 10 crore people to the working population. This is not going to go up. Marginally, it'll go up based on the cost of living only, not because of the supply-demand dynamics. And ultimately, the way to look at it is percentage return on investment. What is my sales revenue minus variable expense? This is my gross margin. Minus fixed expenses. And please note one thing. Don't ever get carried away by these financial experts talking about before interest and depreciation. Pocket ka nahi hai, bhai. Wo paisa rakhna padta hai baju mein. So fixed expenses, interest and depreciation goes up when you automate. Divided by the gross fixed assets and inventory. Now just listen to this. Simple economics, okay? Supposing I automate something and I bring in 100 additional to my gross fixed assets. I don't have a choice. My numerator will reduce by 17. Interest and 10% depreciation. So what am I doing? I'm depressing my numerator. I'm increasing my denominator. My ROI goes for a toss. This is only worthwhile if the people I'm replacing is savings on that is more than 17. In Germany, US, yes. In China, India, no. It won't make economic sense at all. So then after showing all this, my brother-in-law lost interest. Se apna kaam chalta hai. Achha hai, babu. Ye to mar jayenge. Kisko impress karne ka hai? Are you getting it? So look at cost-benefit analysis and always have this ROI as a point. What will kill you is interest and depreciation. And assuming the robot will work continuously, we have mastered the robot. The utilization of robots will be much less than utilization of labor. Please note, I have seen this in industry. I've seen it in India. And one of the companies went into financial sickness. Wrong kind of investment in robot. I told them it's very impressive, but it's not going to be impressive P&L and balance sheet. You are going to suffer like mad. So let's go ahead further. This is based on a study carried out by James Womack of MIT. there was a study conducted on automobile industry. Now, the question which can arise is, how is it relevant? Why is automobile considered so important? An automobile is the most complex mass-produced product on earth. Please note, when you drive an automobile, you are driving 30,000 plus components with you. It is the most complex mass-produced product on earth. And the major changes have come about through automobile industry and got immediately adopted by every other industry. Okay, so we are looking at, and therefore this industry is very intimately studied. Now some 42 or odd companies cooperated in the study. And look at this table. I'm just quickly going to run through. These are Japanese-owned plants running in Japan, US-owned plants running in North America, and European plants, Western Europe mostly. Number of man hours per vehicle, 17, 25, 36, Japan. Quality defects per 100 vehicles, 60, 82, 95. Space occupied, how many square feet per vehicle per year? 5.7, 7.8, 7.8. Repair area in the assembly line is only 4.1% of the repair area. This is 13%, 14%. Inventory, when I'm talking, is WIP, 0.2 days. 3 days, 2 days. This is the most significant part. Number of suggestions per employee in a year. When you have humans, you will have ideas. When you have machines, machines won't think, irrespective of whatever you may say, artificial intelligence and machine learning. The real stuff is when a human works. And look at the training hours they spend on workers. One of the questions asked was, is automation the secret of these Japanese companies? We'll answer that shortly. Another question was, is product variety and under the skin complexity the reason? Are the more productive plants focused on single few standardized products? Conventional wisdom tells us that if you make one or very few product, narrow range and very few varieties, your momentum can be sustained. So are the Japanese producing something like that compared to their American and Western European competitors? The researchers give simple answer, the most productive plant on earth had the maximum products in its range being manufactured and maximum number of varieties of each product in that range. They were not to name names, but I can suspect it must have been the Toyota plant at Toyota City in Japan. So that is not the reason. Now, what about automation? Now, just see this. Look at the graph. Here, there are different regions. There was J-stroke, North America. These were non-industrialized countries. This is a scatter plot. How many man hours go to produce a vehicle is the y-axis. And the x-axis is how many of the processes have been automated? No human being, but automated. The world's most automated plant is here, 48% automation. And the world's most productive plant is here. Now, if you were to draw a line of best fit, what we call as a regression line, it looks sloping downwards. Very clearly, you can conclude that as automation increases, productivity in terms of man hours per vehicle reduces. But is that true? Let's look at this graph again. Look at the next graph. Earlier graph, next graph. Earlier graph, next graph. I have removed automation below 10%. And now you draw the line of best fit. It is flat. That means there is a minimum level you have to automate. Like painting, you can't do manually. But after that, it doesn't add to reduction of man hours. And this is what the researchers had to say. Why were the European and American plants performing so badly? They were high-tech plants. They end up adding many indirect technical and service workers, the maintenance people, who are more costly also. And have low yields because breakdowns in complex machinery reduce the fraction of the total operating time that the plant actually produces vehicles. You see, when it works, it's beautiful. But when something goes wrong, you should see the chaos it creates. Everything comes to a standstill. And this is what the researchers had to say. From observing advanced robotics technology in many plants, we have devised a simple principle that lean organization must come before high-tech process automation if a company is to gain the full benefit. And that is the message I want to give you. First, make your operations lean. And then see whether cost-benefit analysis tells you, do you need to automate or not? Most likely the answer will be no. I'll give you another example. This is by Richard Schonberger, another very credible writer. He visited the Chrysler plant at Trenton City, where they make automobile engines. And these are high-end engines, 2.4, 2.6, 2.2, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.8 liter engines, including turbo variants. This plant is totally automated. Look at the area of the plant, 2.2 million square feet. How many people are employed? 2,250. The plant works 16 hours, two shifts a day. Look at the number of engines they produce, 3,200 engines a day. That is nearly 1 million per year. And what is the operation cycle time? Means I put in raw material, when will the final product come out? Depending on the size, it can be, or the turbo variants, it can be 20 to 40 hours. And they have five superior robots designed by IBM in the assembly line. Schonberger had visited Toyota's plant at Kemigo City, which is called plant number 9. For comparison, he shows this. Why plant number 9? Because plant number 9 also makes 2.2, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6, 2.8 liter engines, including turbo variants. Now see the size of the plant. Mota moti 1:7. In 1/7 the area. Employment 1/13. Output half. Operation cycle time, maal andar dala 4 ghante mein bahar nikalta hai engine. You don't need robots even to track anything in between, and no robots. What is the secret of Toyota Kemigo plant number 9? I'll only show you one. It is equipped with 30 plus years old machines. Actually, many of them bought secondhand. ROI, gross fixed assets in the denominator. They work on lean manufacturing. And then you find there's no need for robots. So first, work on making each process stable, capable, repeatable. And then see the cost benefit. You will find it's not worth it. Everything works in clockwork precision. And that is the interesting feature about this, these plants. Are you clear? I can show you much more details. I'll just skip some of these slides because we'll run out of time. It's fundamentally a lean organization. And we are not questioning quality for either Trenton or Kemigo. Now comes the major case study, Tesla Model 3. Wow, what a car, what a beauty. I've had the privilege of sitting in this car. Fantastic electric vehicle. I landed at Minneapolis, St. Paul's airport, and my son came to pick me up and he had not told me he had bought a Tesla, and I sat in it. I was surprised that he has got one. I couldn't tell him my research shows it was a bad purchase. Now let us see this. 2019 Golden Steering Wheel Award, Car of the Year 2020 in Denmark, Car of the Year 2020 in Norway, Swiss Car of the Year 2020, UK Car of the Year 2020, and what have you. What did Elon Musk do? 95% of the processes were automated. 140 robots plus 10 super robots, whatever that means. He doesn't allow people inside the plant. Okay? And this was his arrogance. This is just going to be a very difficult thing for other manufacturers to copy. I would not know what to do if I were in their position. Now let us see what happened. What was the plan when this plant was set up? In 2017, it will produce 100,000 Model 3, but that was not the capacity. It requires time to stabilize and ramp it up. And by 2018, we'll do 400,000 cars onwards. What happened in actual production? See, 2017, production started only in the second half of the year. and they produce 2,700 cars only. In first half of the year 2018, as against 200,000 in first half, he could produce only 38,000. Then something happened. It jumped up. And what happened? Look at what Elon Musk has to say. Yes, excessive automation at Tesla was a mistake. To be precise, my mistake. Humans are underrated. So even in a high wage labor market, automation may not be the answer. I'll show you a video clipping. Just understand this. I'll keep on halting in between, pausing in between. Automation is good as long as you know exactly where to put the machine, not throughout the factory. Just listen to him. It'll be 7-8 minutes. I'll pause at the right times.
I definitely feel stressed. Yeah, it's like been incredibly difficult and painful the last several months.
The robots are killing Tesla. In a rare win for humans over robots in the battle for labor efficiency, Wall Street analysts have laid down a compelling argument that over-automation is to blame for problems at the billionaire Elon Musk's electric car company. So what went wrong? The Tesla Model 3 production line is heavily automated, and right now that's a problem. During the company's third quarter earnings call, CEO Elon Musk told investment analysts that the $35,000 electric car, which launched this summer to much fanfare, has struggled to reach its lofty production goals because of issues with manufacturing. Automation will certainly prove faster in the long term, but in the short term, Tesla can't switch out its army of robots for humans. In early 2017, Elon Musk told stock analysts that Tesla's goal is to be the best manufacturer on Earth. He'd get there by inventing a factory so dense with robots and devoid of human beings, it would resemble an alien dreadnought video game warship.
We call it the alien dreadnought. At the point in which the factory looks like an alien dreadnought, then you know you've won.
Speed, he said, is the ultimate weapon when it comes to innovation or production. Instead, Tesla this week was forced to bring the Fremont, California production line of its crucial mass-market Model 3 electric sedan to a complete halt. It is at least the second shutdown in the last 2 months. And in an internal email, Musk said Tesla will add workers and go to round-the-clock production to meet its goals. Officially, the company is describing the week-long shutdown of the Model 3 line as planned downtime to improve automation and systematically address bottlenecks in order to increase production rates. That is to say, the very innovation and competitive advantage that Musk says he's bringing to the car industry, his nearly fully automated plant in Fremont, California, is the reason Tesla is unable to scale quickly. According to the Bernstein analysts, it's the robots that can't pump out Tesla's highly anticipated Model 3s fast enough. The whole process is too ambitious, risky, and complicated. Bernstein analyst says, Tesla has tried to hyper-automate final assembly. We believe Tesla has been too ambitious with automation on the Model 3 line. Few have seen it, but we know this. Tesla has spent two times...
I just want you to pay attention to this sentence. Tesla has spent two times what a traditional OEM spends per unit of capacity. The gross fixed assets is twice than what it would be if they would not have automated to that extent. So now look at the ROI equation. Your gross fixed assets in the denominator is twice compared to your competitors who would set up a plant to produce 400,000 vehicles per annum.
Traditional OEM spends per unit on capacity. It has ordered huge numbers of KUKA robots. It has not only automated stamping, paint, and welding, as most other OEMs do, it has also tried to automate final assembly, putting parts into the car. It talks of two-level final lines with robots automating part sequencing. This is where Tesla seems to be facing problems, as well as in welding and battery pack assembly. Insiders in Tesla say automation and final assembly just doesn't work. But hang on a minute. Don't the big auto manufacturers automate too? Not quite. world's best car makers, the Japanese, try to limit automation because it is expensive and is statistically inversely correlated to quality. Their approach is to get the process right first, then bring in the robots, the opposite of Musk's. It's not a problem that Tesla, a highly indebted company, can afford forever. The company's stock has cratered more than 25% in the past month on worries that it will yet again under-deliver on its Model 3 promises. Over the past few days, investors have been selling Tesla's debt in droves. On Tuesday, Moody's downgraded Tesla by one notch to B3, citing a significant shortfall in Model 3 production. During Tesla's fourth quarter earnings call, Musk told investors that factory model assembly was the biggest constraint on Model 3 production. There are tens of thousands of components in each car, he said, and the company can only move as fast as it can correct each problem area. One thing that makes it hard to solve problems in every area, according to Bernstein's analysts, is that they're all automated. Other car companies that have tried this, Fiat and Volkswagen, have also failed. What's more, Bernstein says, this is barely saving Musk money. Let's say there are 10 hours of labor in final assembly, the part of the production line where parts, interiors, and the powertrain are installed in a painted body shell. In a regular plant, final assembly typically has less than 5% of tasks automated. If Tesla attempts to automate 50% of these tasks, it could cut out 5 or so hours of labor. This might save $150 USD per car, assuming wage rates all in of $30 USD per worker per hour. But while all that exotic capital might allow Tesla to remove 5 workers, it will then need to hire a staff engineer to manage, program, and maintain robots for $100 an hour.
I hope you are. Good evening, ma'am. So you can understand, you reduce a 30-hour labor. Madam, can you just
I will try and mute people.
No, it was Kavita has just signed in. I think that noise.
Yeah.
So ultimately, you'll end up adding sophisticated labor. That is maintenance. And this is exactly what happened.
Savings may only be $50 per unit. Yet putting the automation into the plant seems to involve an apparent capital cost that's 4,000 USD higher per unit capacity than for a normal plant.
And the interest and depreciation cost is $4,000 more than a comparable plant. So I'll stop this video and proceed further, okay? So this is what he says, this video says, typically 10 labor hours in assembly per car. It's electric vehicle, there's not much internal combustion engine and other parts. Assuming 5 labor hours cut by automation, at $30 per hour saving is $150 per car. Replaced by one skilled maintenance labor at $100. So what do you save, $50 per car? But higher capital cost, $4,000 per unit of capacity, will mean 575 actually per car of additional depreciation over 7 years. In US, it's 7 years. That is assuming 400,000 cars are manufactured annually. Tesla's Fremont plant has never made money. It will never be able to make money. It cannot make money. And Tesla has shown profits, not through operations. The green points it gets by selling cars, they are selling it to other companies and they are making money on that. Rameshwari, we'll take it all at the end, all questions. You can type it out in the
chat box. Participants can type it on the chat box.
Now, what else is there? Just listen to this. JD Power is a very reputed agency which carries out consumer surveys annually. Now, this is an initial quality study. What do you mean by initial quality? It measures vehicle quality in the first 90 days of ownership. Somebody buys something, consumer durables, they go and interview these people to find out any quality issues they have faced within the first 90 days of ownership. This study is based on responses from 87,282 purchases and leases of the 2020 model year vehicles, all brands. Huh? It was fielded from February through March 2020 before the major lockdowns came. Tesla, before this, never allowed survey to be done on its cars. And even then, they did not allow in the state of California where maximum Teslas have been sold. Now see what happened. The survey results. It was the worst among 32 major brands in his annual quality study. It's the first time Tesla's cars have been ranked. Now in his 34th year. And Tesla's cars suffered 250 problems per 100 vehicles, as reported by customers, compared to an industry average of 166. Interestingly, Land Rover was the second worst. And what were the problems? Body panel accuracy. Body panels don't match. There are rattling noises, wind noises, paint problems. In fact, when I sat in my son's car, I couldn't close the door. So he says, "Dad, you have to pull it." So I said, "That I used to do for Premier Padmini. Band karte the na, darwaza thokna padta tha." To bolta hai, "Oh, aisa hi kar dega." I said, "Then there is a problem in the car." "Then we are going." It's a silent engine. It's electric car. I could hear wind rattling noise. I said, "Ron, I'm able to hear some noise." He is telling me, "Dad, you have become old. So you are imagining things." Who told you you will get quality? That is why we lean first, stabilize, and then you automate. And Bernstein analysts, by the way, were part of the research team at MIT, which researched 42 car manufacturing plants. Okay, earlier at MIT. They had set up their own agency. And this is the final conclusion. One tenet of lean production is stabilize the process and then automate, if at all, cost-benefit wise. If you automate first, you get automated errors. Remember that. One conceptual framework I will give you for you to understand how lean your operations are. Any operating process has series, any operating system has series of processes. Time at which work gets done. I put in raw material, I take out the finished product. Okay? That is called operation cycle time. I put in the product, raw material, I get the finished product. You remember at Chemigo plant number 9 was 4 hours. Elsewhere, it was 20 to 40 hours. Now, why does it happen? So, let us see. So this is the first operation, second operation, third operation, fourth operation. And this is the time at operation number one. Time work gets done. Time work gets done. Time work gets done. If I take the sum total of the time, which is what we call as value-added time, I'll call it TO. Ideally speaking, TO should be very close to cycle time. Ideally. But generally, you'll find TO will be negligible compared to the total time of the operation system. Anywhere you go, any system you observe, an airport is a classic example of understanding how operating systems should not be designed. I enter, get down from my car. Final output is seated in the car with the safety belt on. I came into this operating system to sit in the aircraft. Now, the time I was actually being processed, I am being processed. 3 minutes. Cycle time, domestic airport, 70 minutes. Lean manje kaya. Lean means what? You bring your cycle time down. You remove. These are all wastes. That is lean. Try and understand. There are other things also. These are all wastes. And what are these wastes? Several wastes are there. Moving material, delays for whatever reasons, quality check, large WIP, batch size, setup changeover times, and series of uncertainties, randomly they occur, maintenance downtime, engineering change orders, material shortage, rejection, rework, operator absenteeism, and things like that. They all create this time. One of the biggest problem here is it also eats away your productive capacity. I'm going to skip this. So let us summarize this. Automation is a must. We are very clear. Safety is a concern. Human errors are tiresome, worrisome. Volumes are huge. Humans cannot perform the process. Current process variability by the labor cannot be reduced, and continuous process. So automate if need be. But a process you should automate only after achieving stability. Make it stable, capable, reliable. But even then, when you buy, do not buy the latest technology, buy proven. This is another great mistake our engineers do. And owners and the promoters also get carried away. Sir, you have to buy the latest. Latest manje, latest problems, COVID. Nobody's cheating when they sell you technology, but there are bound to be bugs. There are bound to be problems. There are. And I can talk about one equipment which has been sold worldwide, which goes through thorough testing by regulatory bodies before you can even sell it. You can't market it till it has been regulatory bodies have thoroughly tested and found out. Aircrafts. Look what happened to Dreamliner. It became a nightmare. Look what happened to Boeing 737 MAX. Maximum problems. Look what happened to Airbus 320 Neo. Neo problems. Everything is built into the brand name. There are bound to be. And you are the guinea pig. Haath lagane ka nahi. By proven, 3-4 saal jane do, debug hone do. All the debugging is now happening at your cost. It's like a marriage where divorce is not possible. Le liya machine abhi karega kya? You can't get out of it. Your interest depreciation shuru. Equipment down. So try and achieve leanness before even you think about it. And that too, look at cost benefit analysis. I'll just show you some examples of companies which never went for degree of automation, but they became lean and see the results. HP at Sunnyvale in California, where they make PCs, WIP reduced from 20 days to 3 days. Space reduced sixfold. Aero, distance traveled by material. They now work with nearly 15-16% of the original area. So your expansion doesn't need building costs. Look at Omark. It's a very big company in Oregon where they make circular saw blades, you know, for wood cutting and others. Lead time cut from 10 days to 1 day. WIP cut 85%. None of this was done through automation, my dear friends. Flow distance cut 58%. Operating costs reduced by 35% because of this. Your costs go down. You don't realize when you become lean. GE Cincinnati, where these aviation turbine blades have to go for servicing. And there's no typing error. Lead time cut from 13 weeks to 9 hours. Westinghouse, Pennsylvania, where they make subway controllers. Lead time cut from 12 weeks to 1 week. Floor space cut down from 125,000 square feet to 52,000 square feet. Material storage space cut from 66% to 15%. Harley Davidson, again, motorcycle assembly, lot size cut from 20 to 1. The economic batch size is a bloody hell of a lot of confusing concept. If the market wants one, you make one. You don't make 20 and keep them in stock. Inventory now turns from 3.5 to 20 times in a year. Inventory turnover ratio. Forklifts cut from 65 to 6. Bring the processes together. Inspectors cut from 75 to 6. Work on process stability, capability. Defects per bike down 52%. None of them achieved through automation. John Deere, they also make tractors in India at their Wisconsin plant where they make self-propelled lawn mowers. Sorry for the spelling error, mowers. They cut the lawns. Builds 7 models every day instead of each model once a month. Large batch size. Indirect labor cut half in sub-assembly and fivefold in welding. Burlington Industries, North Carolina. Custom length drapery fabrics. लीड टाइम कट फ्रॉम 4 डेज टू अंडर 1 आवर ऑर्डर दे एक घंटे में माल फैक्ट्री के बाहर WIP कट 97% फ्लोर स्पेस कट फ्रॉम 13,000 स्क्वायर फीट टू 4,300 स्क्वायर फीट Eaton, they are a very large company where they make gears and shafts for automobiles. At the Tennessee plant where they make shafts, time to produce has reduced from 8 days to 28 minutes. TO, samajh mein aaya? WIP cut 98%. Eaton again, where they make transmission cases at Tennessee. Time to produce from 7 days to 2 hours. WIP from 438 cases to 40 cases. Look at Xerox Corporation. Suppliers cut down from 5,000 to 300. Part of your process capability is also because of having multiple suppliers. And Xerox has claimed their raw material came down from 90 days to 30 days. And interestingly, the material cost in the product reduced by 10%. Procter & Gamble at the Torshala plant in Sweden where they may have cough syrup lines. Five-fold reduction of WIP and finished goods inventory. Five-fold. Inventory now turns 4.4 times to 13.5 times inventory turnover ratio. Line changeover time from one cough syrup to the other used to take one shift of 8 hours, now 18 minutes. And they are able to maintain 100% service level. What I'm trying to say is, you feel automation will give you results? Results are possible by becoming lean. I hope you're getting the message. By making your processes lean, your operating system lean. It's a dream. Artificial intelligence. Machine. Chodo yaar, tum. Simple kaam karo pehle. Make your machines last. And all this comes from suggestions per employee per year, please note. It doesn't come just like that. When humans are there, you'll get ideas. The moment you have machines, your ideas stop. I hope you understand the importance of HR now. We want to reduce the headcount. Start doing it in companies, the best headcount will leave. And you'll be left with the worst headcount. Because anybody who gets a job fast will leave fast. Those who are unemployable will remain. So I'll just close this. This is the Toyota way. Read this and then I'll tell you who wrote it. Who said it rather. Value creation on the shop floor results out of human machine combination. Similarly, value creation in admin functions is a result of a combination of human and information communication technology. You need the human face. The TPS approach, Toyota Production System approach is simple. Improve the processes. And only after that, you invest in technology if need be. And look at these harsh words. You commit an evil crime if you first invest in technology before improving the processes. Who is this gentleman? Who is this person? Satoshi Kureiwa. Information Communication Technology Manager of Toyota. He is retired now. He's a consultant and he also teaches at Nagoya University. 34 years of experience with Toyota Motor Company in car production preparation and IT engineering, specialized in factory automation, part logistics and IT enhanced TPS. Here is a person who has ensured responsible for factory automation. Are you clear? So get lean. He says you are committing a crime before improving the process. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I didn't give you a talk. I give you examples. I have got 40 times these examples, 40 multiplied by 40 to give you. And why I'm saying that is, as Deming said, the guru of TQM, in God we trust, everyone else brings data. If you don't have data, don't argue. I have brought information and data from credible sources. In fact, Without data, you are just another person with an opinion. No opinions expressed, data. I only hope you understood. I'm not against it. I'm very clear where it is required, where it is not. My German plants are superbly automated. My US plants are fully automated. My Egyptian plant, Indian plant, much, much less automated, unless those jobs a machine can only do, humans can't. My Chinese plants are not automated, excepting the processes which humans can't. My UK plant is automated. My Russian plant is not. My Mexican plant is partially automated. Cost of labor. I mean, I always jokingly say, why has India's IT sector done so well? Why has it done so well? Nothing. There's nothing in our DNA, IT by IT, kuch nahi hai. It's because of cheap Indian labor. Okay, cheap sound cheap, then we can say cost-effective labor. Simple. We have got the largest workforce available, cost-effective. Don't replace them. Unless safety, very wearisome. But I showed you that carton making is a wearisome job, but we do it manually. I was there in this factory and I said, I'm taking a lecture and I want this. They said, please do, go ahead. They are my clients. I hope you understand. Whenever somebody talks to you, tell them, what are you trying to sell? What are you trying to sell? Remember, return on investment. Tumhara paisa gross fixed asset mein hai. And capital decisions are not reversible. It's like a marriage where divorce is not possible. Are you clear? You're doomed till death do us apart, usually death. So ladies and gentlemen, I end my lecture here. I think I've been able to maintain good time. I'll take some of your questions. Nimish bhai, I'm sorry, but I hope you have been at least comfortable with this. Yeah, any questions you have, you can challenge me. I welcome it. Don't get threatened with my style. I will have the pleasure of mauling you later on. Yeah, follow.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for such a passionate, speech and deliberation. I think you talked about that automation is must. I think that is something, just to recapitulate a few of the points which I could capture, and that one thing which struck me very well was that 90% of the jobs can be automated by the current technology itself, and the savings can be $3 trillion. You threw a lot of numbers and economics, which talks about a lot of practical knowledge and experience, which these students will be gaining through your the session. Then you also talked about stabilizing the process before you automate as the cardinal principle going forward in terms of automation or success in automation, I will say.
Yes, sir.
Then also you said that you must buy a proven technology rather than become a guinea pig, for the newer, by buying the newer technologies. So I think these are some of the big take homes, which were for me and as well as I think must be for the students. Thank you very much for, the way passionately you have put it forward talks a lot about, how much of experience and how much of your energy you have put into the whole process. I will say that. Thank you very much, sir, for that.
My pleasure.
And the first question which I read in the chat box is from Vandan Mangli. He's saying that, what is your opinion about installation of PLC automation, using VFD in motors and pumps in chemical process plant?
My answer was very clear. Chemical process, is it batch or is it continuous process? If it is continuous, no questions asked, you have to automate. So the gentleman concerned can answer me. Are you talking about batch processing where varieties is the name of the game? Can the gentleman answer this?
You can
I got the answer. No, it is continuous. Fine.
Sorry.
So very clearly, it is there where automation is a must. Continuous processing, no questions. You can't manually manage it. So there is very clear. We are very clear. We have to do it. Okay. So I hope I've answered your query.
And the next was that what is the highest benchmark ITR? If that was the question from the person, he can clarify.
Pardon my ignorance. Can you tell me what is ITR first, as you understand it and as I will understand it?
This person is Vikas.
Vikas, no problem. Kindly let me know what do you mean or what do you imply by ITR.
Vikas, you can unmute and speak.
Or type it out.
Sir,
this is the Indian industries. How can best ITR ratio in the Indian industries?
Vikas, my question to you is, what does ITR stand for?
Inventory turnover ratio.
इन्वेंटरी टर्नओवर रेशियो बोलना ऐसा यार ये तुम भी उसको साला व्हाट आई हैव सीन यू आर आस्किंग मी व्हाट आई हैव सीन और व्हाट आई नो ऑफ इन इंडिया
इन इंडिया व्हाट इज द हाईएस्ट बेंचमार्क फॉर आईटीआर दैट्स व्हाट
नो आई विल नॉट यूज इट बेंचमार्क बेंचमार्क शुड बी इनफाइनाइट आई मीन इफ यू रियली आस्क दैट इज द एस्पिरेशन व्हाट आई हैव सीन इज इन द विसिनिटी ऑफ 12 टू 15 In a textile company, I have seen it reach 15, where earlier it was 4. And in a pharmaceutical company where products have a shelf life, you know, shelf life, Salah. We have seen it 12.5 to 15. So that's what I have seen. I am told TVS Sundaram Clayton Group is very, very, very much into lean manufacturing. Bharat Forge is another company which is very much into lean and they have achieved good results. They are coming slightly below 20.
Okay.
It has nothing to do with the Indian environment, weather, Indian culture, Indian thinking. Kuch nahi hai. Are you clear? The best. Okay. Toyota is the best. It will achieve 40. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. And the next question is, how to be lean? Important for our process and systems in manufacturing from Mr. Nimisha.
Oh, I will take a 6-hour lecture. Lean is not something which can be answered in 2 minutes. It's an exercise. It's a journey. And first thing is have faith in your operators. It starts with that. Don't look at them as adversaries. Look at them as partners in the game. You have to first train them. And please understand one thing. Just because somebody has not completed high school doesn't mean the person is not trainable. That is the first problem I face. Oh, they are not trainable. I said, you are the biggest problem in this company. When a manager tells me, and they're really jokingly, I tell him, please resign and join my competitor. It gives me competitive advantage to have such a person in my competition. Everybody's trainable. I mean, I've trained my dog. And I'll use the word, I didn't tame it, trained it, and she enjoyed learning. Everybody is trainable. So never start with that assumption. So it starts with a massive involvement first. So training and then bringing in the concepts and part by part working. I can take a 6-hour lectures. What are the elements of that? So I'll pass that. This is not the forum for that, unfortunately. I'm sorry.
Yeah, yes. Thank you, sir. And the next, Seshwar, you have raised a hand. You can unmute and ask it for yourself.
Yeah, Seshwar. Saishwar, sorry.
Good evening. Yeah, my name is Saishwar Ravikar.
Yes.
Good evening. Sir, in last of your slides, you use the words like human-machine combination. So, sir, in future, there is no guarantee that that combination will not convert into competition. Like the person who are taking the maintenance of that machine, the person can be replaced by robots. So, sir, in that case, sir, how labor can... what will happen? Is there going to be a chaos?
One minute. I'll answer your question in very simple way.
Yeah.
The moment you talk about Industries 4, you talked about Industries 4, right?
Yes.
Please understand, Industries 4, you cannot implement in this country unless the government gives you phenomenal subsidy. Let's be very clear. The interest and the depreciation burden will kill you. will kill you. The break-even point, I have studied this for batch manufacturing, for lean batch manufacturing, and from Industry 4 perspective, creating the case, your break-even point will be three times what you will get from lean. You will never break even. That's the problem. So forget it. And who is going to bear the cost? Who's going to maintain this equipment? You will require phenomenal manpower just to maintain it. So I am not much sold on Industries 4 totally. Anyway, they talk about, you know, IoT devices and all that, which anyway we have been doing without Industries 4. Only Industries 4 is taking credit ki humlo IoT devices will be used to monitor quality and monitor the condition of the machines. Toyota has done it 25 years ago. So what is this? This is just the German terminology. Germany has a problem declining workforce. What do you think they are welcoming? Migrants. There are no people to work. And do you know how much the German government subsidizes Industries 4 where companies have implemented?
No.
So it's an engineer's dream with government subsidy. It's not sustainable.
Yes, sir.
Number two, I'm told there is a factory of Bosch in Bangalore where they have done Industries 4.
Okay.
For the last 3 years, I've asked for an invitation to visit the factory. They have not given it to me.
Okay.
So I don't know what is happening there. Now I am open. I want to learn. Including two of my students working in Bosch. And they just smile and say, sir, it will not be possible. I say, kya baat karta hai? What are you hiding? So I don't know. We have to see it still. Yes.
And so next is SN Sanghvi.
Yes, Sanghvi sahab.
Sanghvi sahab, you can unmute and ask question.
Call after half an hour, please. Yeah, Sanghvi sir.
Yes, sir. First of all, it's a wonderful listening to you and your presentation. Fantastic.
Thank you, sir.
Your style is more like KBC Big B. I have Elon Musk ke baare mein bataya. So I have read his autobiography and I'm sort of like, I'm inspired by him quite a lot. So one thing I saw that he like works like 14 hours per day and like, since his childhood. So would you like to throw some light on that? Unless you work that hard, you can't reach that height, because he's the top CEO, the owner of that company, and he himself works hard so much. Rather in India or other places, we see that the CEOs and all, they will make the staff to work hard. They themselves are not so much.
Well, let me intervene here.
Yeah.
I admire Elon Musk from his innovation perspective.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
But I don't like his arrogance.
Very true.
Number one. Number two, he has taken home billions and billions and billions of dollars when his companies have made a loss. And I don't like it. If I was a shareholder, I would have raised it.
Okay.
Tesla has not made money. They have been making money by selling green points. Now, Sanghvi sahab, I have no idea. I have not conducted any survey or research because that's not my area of how much working hard leads to success. Mere ko malum nahi hai, sir. So I go by facts. Otherwise, I'll just express an opinion. But I was brought up by one boss, my first mentor, Mr. Dinanath Joshi, the late Mr. Dinanath Joshi. He said, if you can't complete the job in 8-hour shift, you are useless. You are not efficient. You are wasting time. So start becoming productive. Use your time effectively. Now, maybe creativity is a field where you need to work more hours. I don't know. I have not researched it, sir.
Okay. Okay. Very true. Very true.
Okay. Right.
He is also promoting so much of cryptocurrency.
I don't know. I am not in that area, sir. I'm an operations person. Mera competence nahi hai udhar. Mere ko malum nahi hai kuch bhi. Honestly. Yeah, Atul.
Hello, sir. My name is Atul. I am from MMS batch of 2023 from Delhi. Sir, I wanted to ask that considering the recent conditions of pandemic and manufacturers are living in the constant fear of pandemic, there is a lot of uncertainty about the future also. Don't you think automation will solve this problem of reducing the human interaction?
You are adding one more uncertainty, automation, to it. What was I saying? Stabilize the process first, then automate if need be. If the cost-benefit analysis turns out to be, let me also tell you, I have 9 live clients right now. None of my clients laid off anybody. Why? We are lean. We are cash rich. We are lean and we are cash rich. So please try and understand. Uncertainties can keep on coming and going. They will come, they may not come. But you must have the capability. Lean has the capability of absorbing any kind of shocks, including pandemics. Are you clear? Yeah, Nimish bhai, sorry.
Yeah. Sir, correct me if I am wrong. What I understand from today's session of yours,
yes, sir,
is that improving your processes and systems and eliminating possible wastage from processing system is more important than going for automation. Is it correct?
Absolutely right, sir. You got it perfectly right. But at the same time, I will add that we are also very clear where there's no debate required. Automation is a must. So that is not to be debated. In the other areas, reducing headcount is not the answer. I need workmen who can think. It is my job to create thinking workmen. In fact, one good book, you know, The Fifth Discipline by Peter Senge, the title of the book itself talks it. The Fifth Discipline, The Art and Practices of a Learning Organization. You have to create a learning organization, and he talks about the methodology, how to develop that organization. We have to do that, sir. I have full faith, sir. I have worked with rascals, so-called. I have had the privilege of working with Kishan Tulpule, who was a nasty union leader. I had no problems. I had an encounter with Datta Saman. I had no problems. I worked in a company where RJ Mehta, they were all dead, by the way. I'm still alive. Very nasty, I was told. I had no problems, sir. We have to remove their anxiety that they will lose the jobs. And I am a little bit of left-leaning capitalist. I don't want people on the road. Everybody has some problems, sir. They have EMIs to pay. They have old parents to look after, grandparents to look after. I don't believe in it. Very rarely when integrity issues arise, we have no choice. Otherwise, the same person, we can do things. That's our job. So I'm a firm believer in that, sir. And I've spent my lifetime, barring 9 years where I flirted with marketing and HR and advertising, back to operations. I've spent my lifetime on the shop floor. I love it. I love talking to workmen. I love exchanging jokes with them, getting work done. It's fun. It's not a challenge. We have to understand them and work with them. They are my assets. We call them assets. But HR calls them cost to company. Abhi kya bolega?
Sir, another question I have.
Yes, sir.
Japanese companies are following this Kanban and all this lean and all concepts. But they have not succeeded as far as these systems and processes are concerned. Is it because of their aged population, aged or workforce, or what is it?
I don't know, honestly, but aging workforce does lead to drop in productivity. Of course, there are exceptions like you and me. We can become aged, but our productivity won't go down, but we are beyond the 3 sigma limits. So, yes, but that discipline still exists in the well-known Japanese companies about the Kanban system, sir. It still exists. It does exist. I hope I answered your query, sir. Right. Tarun,
sorry, I think I got your answers, and thank you very much, sir. I think Mr. Tarun also
Yes, sir. It is a privilege, you know, hearing you after almost 9 years. Mm-hmm. I used to be a student attending your classes. I'm still nervous asking you.
Arey, I'm not that cruel. Come on.
You're still very polite.
Yeah, Tarun, tell me.
Sir, I have a question. In the context of, because, you know, when we speak, maybe, you know, in all your talks and in this particular talk also, most of the data and the examples that you highlighted are particularly pertinent to the manufacturing industry. So what is your take, the scope of automation or the application of automation in services industry like insurance, where I work as an innovation manager, currently. Yeah, so I just want to take, it's a very broad question, but still I want to know because.
I agree. Let me butt in here. Digitization is a must. I mean, just look at the banks working, 15 years ago and today. Digitization is simple, error-free. You remember one of the reasons for automation is error-free. And improve the speed. So digitization in services like yours, insurance, banks, toll nakas, etc. It's bound to come. It has happened and it's going to happen at an increasing pace. But service organizations like a warehouse, I don't see where automation is required. I'll give you an example. I was invited as a speaker at a seminar. I don't like to go personally, but there's emotional blackmail, So I went. But I requested I'll be the last speaker. 6 speakers before me spoke about how great this is and how great they are. They are all representing their companies trying to sell something. There was one speaker before me. She showed some video clippings of automated guided vehicles in a warehouse and this and that and phalana dimka karke bahut kuch impress kiya. Mera time has, I told them I have nothing to sell, but I have questions to ask. This kind of automated guided vehicles which you're trying to sell, what is the investment required by that company and who is going to maintain it? Annual maintenance contract ka cost kya aega? I have an alternative. Why don't you make your flooring of the warehouse smooth? And why don't you teach your workmen to roller skate? It'll be faster than your automated guided vehicle.
Yeah.
It's not a joke. It can be done and I have done it. We have seen it in Indore in a big warehouse. Conveyor belts and either beautiful trolley leke roller skate karke jaake maal leke aate barcode green karke and gives it to the packing department. I said, what is the return on capital employed? Return on investment dekho tum. I said, you can't sell, we normally people say, a good marketing man is who can market a refrigerator to an Eskimo. And I said, that is stupidity. You don't sell something which the other person doesn't need. Why the hell are you saying selling something which the other person doesn't need? Understand that person's problem and give a solution rather than selling something which you have to offer. So I hope I've answered. Digitization, Tarun, has happened, will happen in an increasing way. And insurance also belongs to that category of service where there is nothing but service being delivered. It's a service. We don't feel it. The only thing is when we get it, we know it. Okay?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And Tarun, my best wishes to you and your family.
And I must say, it's an absolute privilege. When I heard about, about this particular session, I thought, I'm not going to miss it. So,
my pleasure. Yes. Any other question?
Yes, there is a question on YouTube by Abhishek Patel, which says that do you think AI automation would impact the IT services industry as disruptively as automation affected manufacturing? And also in continuation, he's saying, what would the impact of same be on the future workforce at a macroeconomic level?
Well, I don't think it's going to happen in a big way in India because there are going to be social problems, first of all. One thing it will lead to is increased employment in AI-related industry. It is going to increase there, but there is not enough capacity available. I mean, it's not going to be an infinite capacity. Please try and understand IT, artificial intelligence or augmented intelligence will all depend on your algorithm. I have a client. they bought some package where computations would be done and the algorithm gives solutions every week what to do. So I found that we are still not improving. I was not appointed when they bought the package. I wanted to speak to the developers and I asked them, don't give me the code, but at least tell me what algorithms have you designed? What is your mathematical model which you have designed, which accumulates data and gives me an optimum solution? So my biggest worry is the designers of the AI don't have enough competent people to advise them what to design. Do they have industry experts? So this is my fear. So a lot of people will buy because it's in fashion. हमने भी खरीदा, यू नो, वे अमेरिकी प्रोवाइड, ये है वो है, फलाना है, दिन का है, घंटा कुछ नहीं है उधर. Sorry for using software language. You put in garbage, you'll get garbage out. So AI is good, but what is the algorithm? So afterwards, I told them, bloody hell, you modify. This is not giving me optimal. It's like SAP implementation, SAP implement karne aata hai, ERP. The fellow who comes to implement doesn't understand my business and is advising me what to do. In one client company, I was told to deal with these guys. So I told them, listen, mere ko ye inventory modeling mangte hai. Bolte, nahi, aap aisa karo, ye hamara model hai, wo aisa karega tumhare liye. I said, don't tell me what you have. Listen to what I want. So the problem is the availability of experienced people who are guiding these people. That is my reading. Okay. Yes, sir. Any other one?
Next is how much automation is required in industry 4.0? Should companies focus on KPIs?
अरे बाबा KPI BPI से कुछ काम होने वाला नहीं है, वो नाटक है. आई एम वेरी वेरी क्लियर, ऑल नाटक, छोड़ दो उसको. हाउ मच शुड यू फोकस ऑन इंडस्ट्री 4.0? वेयर इज इट? वी हैव येट टू सी इट. इट्स ऑल टॉक. आई एम नॉट सीन इट. आई मेंशन इट बोल्डली. एंड इफ समबडी फ्रॉम Bosch इज हियर एंड लिसनिंग, प्लीज इनवाइट मी टू सी. आई वॉन्ट टू सी वॉट यू हैव डन. Where? What will you do? I'll show you some videos if time permits later on, or maybe in another lecture. Do you know what it means? Do you know the kind of maintenance skills required? You will not break even. 12 saal lagega. First of all, OEE crashes in Industries 4. Nobody seems to be talking about it. Equipment utilization crashes in Industry 4. And then the first thing you keep in mind, what's the utilization of my resources? Industries 4 leads to flexibility, but nobody is saying flexibility karne ke liye tumhara utilization will crash. Highly automated system crashing. How will you recover? Tumhara break even nahi aayega. Your utilization will be below 50%. My judgment tells me, it's an opinion I'm expressing from what I have studied. Yes, sir.
So next question is from Tejas, which says that, sir, you shown a graph and explained that some sort of minimum automation is necessary, but any automation after that will not reduce man hours. Yeah. So 10 to 15 years down the line, is this the lower limit bound to increase? If yes, what will be the factors responsible for it?
My reading is it will not going to increase. You know, this 10-15% will remain. There are processes like painting, so many micron thickness, uniform, no human being can give. It will have to be automated. So there are some parts of the processes you don't have a choice. You know, questions asked, consistent thickness. You can only do it through robots. It's very clear. All I'm saying is don't buy the latest. That's all. Udhar to lagega hi. I'm not against it. But inserting seats inside the car, do you need a robot? Inserting an engine in the car body, do you need a robot? This is what Tesla tried to do. So I don't see it increasing if sane people are around. You can increase it if you want to, if you want to kill the company. I call it complicated suicide. You know, when engineers come, sir, we must install this. Whoa. So I tell them, you are the biggest risk to the company. Please resign and join my competitor. It gives me competitive advantage. Sir, cost will go down. I said, you are the biggest cost. Please go. But I'll give you a good farewell. Main 3 mahine ka pagar bhi dunga tere ko jaane ke liye. It's not arrogance. It's to make sure that these fellows think differently. Yes, sir.
And sir, the next is from Yash, which says that, what is your take on the automation in construction industry, considering China has made rapid advances in the same and its impact in India, as traditionally construction in India has been labor intensive?
No. Let me tell you, I don't know, because these are only video clippings that one sees about Chinese construction. But there is possibility of using 3D technology for construction that I'm aware of. And Larsen and Toubro have been experimenting with it. So with 3D printing, you can do construction with proper reinforcement, and that will happen. But these are yet to be tested against severity of weather, etc. So I don't see much scope happening, because these things will become costly. Will people be able to afford? That is the problem. So costliness is a major thing. What will you charge the people? वो कारागिर काम करता है कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट पे, उसको कितना मिलता है दिन का? 300 रुपया 250 रुपया मिलता है। तुम 50 आदमी को भी रिप्लेस करेगा, तुम्हारा क्या सेविंग होगा ऑटोमेशन से? और वो ऑटोमेशन चढ़ाना पड़ेगा फ्लोर आफ्टर फ्लोर, एंड देन यू हैव टू मेंटेन दैट इन अ कंस्ट्रक्शन साइट। देयर आर इश्यूज, दो आई हैव नॉट स्टडीड इट, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट आई हैव नॉट स्टडीड इट, बट आई नो the 3D printing has been experimented with by Larsen and Toubro. I don't know the outcome, but that's one company. That is why I said level of preparedness of technology. So you must try all this in small way and see, learn from it. Don't jump into it. If somebody asked something about China Hub, hey boss, I don't know how many of the Chinese company really make money. Is profit their motive, or employment was their motive when they started? Why are Chinese goods so cheap? You don't have any reliable figure about the GDP, etc. Chinese 30% of the GDP came through construction, actually. And the Communist Party chief in that division has a target, kitna aadmi log ko employ karke itna sales achieve karna hai. Profit has never been the motive. So are we comparing like to like? Apple to apple, it's a different ball game, and US gave it a favored nation status. So who bought these Chinese goods? Mostly Americans, and gave it a flip to come out of their mess they were in. And they thought by improving the status of China, they will become more anti-communists. It never happened. So American philosophies have not worked, actually, everywhere they tried. So I don't know. I mean, Chinese figures are not reliable. We were a multinational company, Indian company operating in China. My figures were very reliable.
I think you had mentioned about some book. So some people want to know if you can repeat the name of that book.
I'll type it out in chat. The Fifth Discipline, is it? That is the one?
Yeah, I think that is the book you mentioned. The Fifth Discipline.
The Fifth Discipline is a masterpiece. The Fifth Discipline by Peter Sanji.
And then there's a question which says that if 3D printing cycle time increases, would it increase automation percentage required everywhere? And also, as Tesla announced with mold car frames, would that lead again higher automation and quantity?
Listen, I have only read about it. We have not yet seen that car, which is one molded body at bottom. I have read about it. I closely follow Tesla. But has the car come on the road? I don't think so far. Also, you know, Elon Musk's thinking is much faster than what is doable. You know, when we talk about autonomy in driving, autonomy in level 6 is total. You have no control on the car. You just state where you want to start and where it should end. That is level 6. Nowhere we are level 2. Level 1 is where the driver controls the car. Level 2, you have to keep your hand on the car, and even that has created a problem. So now every car will have a camera which will monitor the driver's behavior and movements. So we are still at level 2. So we to bahut baki hai karne ka. I hope it sees the lights of the light of the day. So somebody asked me about 3D printing. I don't know. I didn't understand the question.
So can I repeat that? Maybe.
Yeah, please, sir.
It is, if 3D printing cycle time increase, would it increase automation percentage?
1 minute.
Required everywhere. I don't know.
I don't understand this question.
I also did not.
3D printing cycle time increases, is it?
Anybody? It is some
3D printing as such is automation. 3D printing is automation. It is automation, and it has beautiful advantages in prototyping, not in manufacturing, is my view. It has fantastic applications in prototyping. Okay. So I don't know about cycle time. I mean, if you're making prototypes, you try any other way, the cycle time will be high. 3D printing will be the lowest. Yes, sir.
I think if anybody has any question, you can raise your hand and ask the question, because in chat box, there are no more questions. I think you have been so kind enough to answer each and every question, sir. With so much of depth in every answer which you have put in.
Thank you, sir.
So thank you very much, sir, for a wonderful session, insightful. I being out of this, whole industry, but still I have a lot of takeaways. Because you know, whenever I buy as a layman, I buy the new technology, but today my take is different from you. yes, you were saying, sir, sorry.
Yeah, only one last message before we leave.
Yeah.
As I said, safety is not negotiable. That's my favorite sentence. So I will hope and pray that each one of you, as well as your family members, remain safe. Don't take chances. Wear a mask when you're out in public. And also try and keep social distance, please. And I will hope and pray not only you, but your family members remain safe. And Rajesh Saab, thank you very much for inviting me to be a speaker. It was a privilege and an honor to be a speaker at this forum. Thank you, sir.
So thank you very much, sir, for sparing time for BMA, and especially for these young minds who have been looking forward to your session. I can see from the attendance itself and at the right time when they had joined at the start of the session, there were 200 plus people. It was a glitch from our side, for which I apologize. Later on got corrected. And I thank all my EC members who have been part of this program, our past presidents, and also current president Kavita Ji, who joined in between. In spite of her busy schedule, she was there. And I also urge upon people who are not member of BMA to become a regular member, life member of BMA, because we bring a lot of knowledge and experience to the table for the benefit of all the members. And also request all of you to keep attending our Wednesday Wisdom webinars, and also Friday Fundamentals, which we keep doing it. Look forward to attending. I also thank BMA Secretariat for doing a wonderful job for organizing such sessions. So thank you very much, sir, once again for sparing time. And
thank you,
sir. Look forward to interacting with you post the session.
Yes, sir. Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Good night. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much.